Chapter 1, Small Town Youth, Ling Town, Early Morning. Young Kinlai blankly got out of bed as the sky had just begun to brighten. After a simple freshening up, he walked directly toward Ling Dining Hall. The rough linen attired Kinlai had a slim figure and could be considered delicate. However, his eyes were vacant, without any trace of vigor, causing others to feel as though he had lost his soul. Along the way, many of Ling Town's young martial practitioners had also woke up early. Upon seeing young Kinlai, many of them smiled kindly. Good morning, Kinlai. Seeing Kinlai enter, Ling Feng grinned brightly, calling out to him as he waved. Unfortunately, it seemed as though Kinlai was not able to hear other people's voices. His expression was still as blank as before. He passed by Ling Feng without ceasing his footsteps, and continued onward. Big brother Feng, why do you bother talking to a fool? You obviously know that he can't respond, yet you always greet him every day in the morning. A bright yellow attired, well-endowed 16-year-old Ling Yin casually commented as she looked at Kinlai with contempt. She looked rather dainty, and her soft chest that provoked fanciful thoughts stood tall. After hearing what Ling Ying had said, the expressions of the surrounding youths from Ling family all went cold, as they grew annoyed. Ling Ying huffed. Her pretty face was full of disdain as she lifted her full chest, turning a blind eye to everyone's gazes. Most of those youths were at the fourth or fifth level of refinement, and were simply regarded as unimportant to her, who had already reached the sixth level of refinement. The only one in her eyes was Ling Feng, who had reached the seventh level of refinement. Ling Feng slightly frowned. Little Ying, you haven't been at Ling Town for that long, which means you have never received any of Kinlai's grandfather's benefaction, so I won't blame you for having your own views about Kinlai. However, we children of Ling family have all been helped out by Grandpa Qin Shan when he was still healthy. Even though Grandpa Qin Shan passed away 2 years ago, we still remember all the care he showed us in our hearts. On behalf of all of us, I hope you can show Kinlai the proper respect. Ling Yin was momentarily stunned. His grandpa's really strong? Grandpa Qin Shan was an artificer. Ling Feng softly yelled. Ling Ying said in deep reverence, common, profound, earth, heaven, divine, with each level again differentiated into seven ranks. What level of an artificer was he? Has he forged any spirit artifacts for the Ling family? No. Ling Feng shook his head. Grandpa Qin Shan only knew how to repair spirit artifacts below common grade 5. AI, scared me to death. And I wondered how awesome he was. He's only at that level? Ling Ying patted her well-endowed chest, evidently making an exaggerated smile. To us, that is already really awesome. Ling Feng's expression did not waver as he continued in an undercast tone of voice. 5 years ago, when Grandpa Qin Shan came to Ling Town with Kinlai, he sought our patriarch and had a discussion about the cost of helping us repair our common spirit artifacts. He asked for the right to extract ores from all those various mines in Herb Mountain, and for us to allow him and Kinlai to live in Ling Town. 3 years later, Grandpa Qin Shan took Kinlai back and forth from Ling Town to Herb Mountain's mines. In that period of time, Grandpa Qin Shan was in charge of repairing every spirit artifact lower than common grade 5. As long as its level did not pass common grade 5, he was able to completely restore it to its original shape, no matter how severely damaged the spirit artifact, without any trace of it ever having weakened. Poof! Firelight ignited on top of Ling Feng's wrist, and the scarlet bracelet on his wrist suddenly lit up with many colors. Soon after, that scarlet bracelet miraculously transformed into a glowing hammer. The hammer was only half his arm long, and its entire body was dark red. Clumps of fiery clouds were branded on the spherical part of the hammer like tattoos, and exuded blasts of burning waves of heat. My fire cloud hammer is a common grade 2 spirit artifact and is my lifeblood. 5 years ago in Glacial Mountain Range, an ice soul python blasted a mouthful of cold energy into my body. My fire cloud hammer helped me withstand the cold energy and had luckily saved me, but it was severely damaged. If not for Grandpa Qin Shan helping me repair my fire cloud hammer, it'd probably be scrapped a long time ago. There are many of our Ling clansmen whose spirit artifacts had also been severely damaged, but thanks to Grandpa Qin Shan, those damaged spirit artifacts were able to be repaired. Otherwise, our clan would have encountered incomparable losses. Ling Feng lamented as he looked at Kinlai's figure from afar. But he's already died from an illness 2 years ago. Ling Ying said in astonishment. Our Ling family knows gratitude. Kinlai is just too pitiful. He was already like this when he came to Ling Town with his grandfather 5 years ago. When Grandpa Qin Shan was here, there were some who took good care of him. But following Grandpa Qin Shan's death, in these 2 years, sigh. Ling Feng changed topics, then couldn't help but sigh. Then is a second miss more pitiful? I heard that the patriarch had promised Qin Shan that second miss and Kinlai would get engaged on second miss birthday 15 birthday next month. Since you're a native Ling Town person, can you tell me if such a thing happened? Ling Ying suddenly lowered her voice and came closer to Ling Feng. She whispered, why would the patriarch agree to second miss and Kinlai's engagement? Isn't this just like pushing second miss into a pit of fire? Not sure. Ling Feng was also unclear about that. To him, even if the patriarch had made such an agreement with Qin Shan, after Qin Shan's death, that agreement shouldn't count anymore. Dot. Ling Dining Hall. Three four-sided wooden tables were put together to form a huge, long rectangular table. Steamed buns, porridge, and various side dishes were arranged upon the tabletop. Ling family's patriarch Ling Chengzi sat upright in the head seat. Beside him on each side was his sister-in-law, Du Jialin, and third brother Ling Chengzi. Next to Du Jialin were her two sons, Du Heng and Du Fu. As for the girls beside Ling Chengzi, they were his eldest brother's daughters, Ling Yuxi and Ling Zhuangxun. Ling family had three brothers. The eldest was Ling Chengzi, second Ling Chengui, and the third was Ling Chengzi. 10 years ago, When Ling Chengui broke through into the natal opening realm, he underwent a fiendish rebound and died by bodily explosion. His wife Du Jialin brought her similarly surnamed two sons, Du Heng and Du Fu, to live in Ling family, and use Ling family's resources to continue cultivating. Boundless oceans existed within this world named Spirit Realm, and upon these oceans were many continents. On these continents, all sorts of people and races unceasing refine themselves with a spirit energy prevalent everywhere, eternally pursuing the world's ultimate mysteries. Here, strong practitioners stood tall like high mountains and peaks, possessed world-shocking apocalyptic spirit artifacts, and some strict martial forces with status covered every remote corner of this world like spiderwebs. Here, not only did martial practitioners and spirit artifacts have distinct divisions of levels, even clans, sects, and merchant guilds formed intercrossing networks of complex factions. They also had strict social strata. Spirit realms cultivation of the martial way was divided into 10 realms: refinement, natal opening, manifestation, nether passage, fulfillment, fragmentation, nirvana, imperishable, void, and genesis. The basic refinement realm was composed of 9 levels, while the latter realms were subdivided into small levels of early, mid, and late stages. Similarly, mystical spirit artifacts and strong artificers also had a distinct division of levels. They were common, profound, earth, heaven, and divine, with each level also possessing 7 ranks. What was even more peculiar was that even those clans and sectoral forces had their own divisions of levels. They were divided into 5 ranks: limestone, black iron, copper, silver, and gold, and were restricted in layers like a pyramid. The lowest limestone rank powers were spirit realm's most basic forces, and their numbers were so many, they were uncountable like specks of sand within a desert. They had no choice but to attach themselves to larger powers, rely on them to survive and cultivate, and allow their dignity to get trampled on. As for those gold rank forces at the apex of the pyramid, they were all the most glorious peak existences. Not only did they have access to the strongest martial practitioners in the world, they had the most mystical of spirit artifacts, the widest or vein territories, the most mysterious of forbidden secret realms, and they even commanded many silver, copper, black iron, and limestone ranked forces. Any order they passed down were capable of changing the color of the world, dye mountains and river into the red of blood, and annihilate millions and millions of living creatures. And Ling family was merely a small clan power that wasn't even of the limestone rank. Ling family and its surrounding small families all attached themselves to Ice Stone City's limestone ranked force, Nebula Pavilion. They had to send enough offerings to Nebula Pavilion every year in order to obtain Nebula Pavilion's protection, and live in Ling Town. Tap, tap. The sound of footsteps that came from afar approached. Not long after, Qin Lai's figure punctually appeared. He mechanically sat in the seat opposite Ling Chengai with a blank expression on his face, then lifted his rice bowl and began to eat. Over the past 5 years, Qin Lai always arrived right on time for early morning breakfast. Even though Qin Lai was a fool in the eyes of everyone in Ling Town, his habit of being on time for meals had never changed. For the first 3 years, it was always Qin Shan who had brought him over. After Qin Shan's death, Qin Lai came alone, and still maintained this custom. After eating breakfast every day, Qin Lai would enter the herb mountain behind Ling Town and go into those mines within the mountain. Only until it turned dark would he return to Ling Town before supper. After having the evening meal with the Ling family, he would return to his residence to rest, day after day, year after year. This was how he lived, without any ripple or change in his lifestyle. It had been 5 years, yet no one knew what exactly he and his grandfather were doing to spend so much time in Herb Mountain's mines. Even Patriarch Ling Chengai had always been puzzled. Hey! Du Fu suddenly couldn't help but sneer. He slanted his eyes and glanced at Qin Lai, then taunted mockingly, "My future brother-in-law's table manners aren't bad. It's fine even if he gets engaged to Xuanxun next month. Just pretend that you're raising an odd, cute, obedient dog." After he finished speaking, Du Fu laughed weirdly while looking in Ling Xuanxun's direction. Ling Xuanxuan's delicate body that was wrapped in fiery red leather armor was already beginning to show the first signs of appeal. She had an extremely small elegant face, spirited intelligent eyes, yet her barely 15-year-old self's reputation was widespread. Bang! Ling Xuanxuan's halfway exposed jade white hand heavily slammed on the table. The rice bowl in front of her violently leaped up due to the impact, and the unfinished porridge splashed toward Du Jialin's family of three who were sitting on the opposing side. Even though the three's reaction speed was extremely fast, they were still splashed into a miserable state by the porridge. "I'm not going to get engaged to him even if I die." Without waiting for Du Jialin to get angry, Ling Xuanxuan quickly got up. Not even caring about her father Ling Chengai's unsightly expression, she charged out of the room like a ball of flame. After encountering the wooden door, she swung her little hand and an orange-colored flame suddenly shot out, splitting the wide wooden door apart. Before the 10 or so pieces of broken wood had time to fall on the ground, Ling Xuanxuan's exquisite figure had already disappeared. Just as Ling Chengai was prepared to angrily admonish her, he was suddenly stunned in place. He looked at the broken-down pieces of wood, then his eyes slightly lit up, as he revealed a thoughtful expression. "Big brother. When did Xuanxuan step into the 7th level of refinement? The emission of spirit energy. This is clearly an indicator of the 7th level of refinement," Ling Chengzi said with uncontained excitement. His entire face was filled with pleasant surprise. To have stepped into the 7th level of refinement at 15, Xuanxuan's natural talent is even more shocking than Yushi. At her current rate, she will surely be able to step into the natal opening realm before the age of 20. In the future, she will definitely be able to receive Nebula Pavilion's good graces. Ling Chengzi restrained his inner excitement, coughed lightly, and asked Ling Yushi, "When did Xuanxuan break through?" Ling Yushi, who donned a long green dress, had her dark, long hair spread over her shoulders. The expression on her delicate face was as graceful as an orchid flower. Her skin that was as white as jade and her figure that seemed tall and slender even when sitting down, caused the gaze of Duheng, who was sitting on the side, to heat up, as his gaze wouldn't even move away from her body for even an inch. She just broke through 7 days ago. At first, she wanted to immediately rush over and tell Daddy this news, but she changed topics and sighed lightly. But 2 days ago, she unexpectedly heard about Daddy already having promised Grandpa Qin Shan that she will be engaged to King Lai on her birthday. So she didn't continue, but Ling Cheng I had already guessed the cause with a helpless expression. Whoosh. Right at this moment, Qin Lai, who acted as though no one else was present and was immersed in eating, suddenly stood up as though he had not heard anyone speaking or clashing. Just like how he had acted in the past, he left after eating his fill. He headed directly toward the herb mountain behind Ling Town. Big brother, I have a few words I want to discuss with you in private. Ling Chengzi also suddenly got up and shot his elder brother a meaningful look. After Qin Lai had left, he also left the dining hall. Ling Cheng I followed behind him with a pensive look on his face. On the rugged uneven mountain path, Ling Cheng I and Ling Chengzi maintained a steady distance from Qin Lai while also walking in the direction of Herb Mountain. The two's gazes swiftly landed on Qin Lai's body, as they chatted in a low voice. It's been 5 years. Since the time Qin Shan had brought Qin Lai over, this grandfather-grandson pair were always in the mines during the day. Big brother, aren't you curious about what they were doing in the mines? What they discovered? Of course I'm curious. But I had an agreement with Qin Shan to not charge into the mines without reason. Besides, our Ling family have already cleared Herb Mountain's mines for many years, and never found any valuable spirit stones. Else, why would I promise the mines to that grandfather-grandson pair? And what exactly is going on with Xuangsun and Qin Lai's engagement? Big brother, I know you would never sacrifice Xuangsun's lifelong happiness. So why? Before Qin Shan passed away, he adamantly wanted me to agree to this matter. On behalf of all the help he gave us these few years, I made the promise with gritted teeth. But it isn't like how you think it is. He probably wished that Qin Lai would be able to continue being looked after by our Ling family after he passed away. What do you mean? It is merely an engagement. Qin Lai and Xuangsun are both 15 years old. He requested for us to take care of Qin Lai until he turned 17. Once Qin Lai turns 17, any one of us could break off the engagement. The reason why this engagement exists is because he wanted Qin Lai to have the status of a son-in-law, so that our Ling family members won't mess around with him, that's all. Don't worry. Xuangsun has already broken through into the 7th level of refinement. She will definitely enter Nebula Pavilion in the future. I obviously will not allow Qin Lai to influence her future prospects. When the time comes, I will immediately break off the engagement. So that's how it is. Ling Chengzi nodded. He muttered, Big brother, I have something that I'm not sure whether I should say, sigh. If you have something to say, just say it. Ling family's patriarch shouted with a frown. Based on what you have said, the engagement is merely for appearance's sake. If that's the case, Xuangsun doesn't really have to get engaged to Qin Lai. Isn't also possible for him to get engaged to Yushi instead? Even though Yushi is 2 years older than Qin Lai, there should be no harm in that, right? Ling Chengzi probed. Ling family's patriarch's complexion suddenly darkened. Big brother, since sister-in-law had passed away much too early, I know that you love Yushi and Xuangsun both equally. I am also the same. Ling Chengzi considered his phrasing, and said sincerely, however, even an engagement could influence a girl's reputation. Xuangsun is only 15, but she actually reached the 7th level of refinement. Even in normal times, you and I could see her talent for cultivation and her comprehension of spirit arts far surpass Yashi's, Xuangsun's future. Absolutely cannot be bound. She will become our Ling family's true hope. When the conversation reached here, Ling Chengzi's expression became respectful. In the future, Xuangsun will enter an even higher world of martial practitioners, reach a level that we can't even hope to attain. Under this kind of situation, there is a chance that she could marry into a powerful force whose power we can't even imagine. However, if she has a past engagement, then she'll have a stain. This will affect her future prospects. Third brother, you are becoming more and more pragmatic. Ling family's patriarch shook his head and sighed. Allow me some time to think about this, sigh. With Yushi's gentle temperament, I know that she will definitely agree to this if I ask her to bear this burden, but I just can't do this to her. For the clan's future, and also for Xuangsun's future, I ask Big Brother to seriously consider this. Ling Chengzi said with persuasion. Ling family's patriarch remained silent for a long time. After a long while, he finally spoke. Let's not talk about this for now. You've always been in charge of Herb Mountain and I've never asked you about it much. Why are you insisting on taking me to Herb Mountain today? You'll understand when we get there. I have a faint feeling that this matter may have something to do with Qin Lai.